Welcome along to Star Lane. We're just a couple of miles south of Stratford in East London today. Beautiful, gorgeous day here. And we're here for another challenge. There's myself. Of course, I will be doing the easy bit by taking the Docklands Light Railway that you can see behind me. Whilst Alistair will be doing the running between the two points. Now, we're running from here, Star Lane, to Greenwich Station. Now, on a tube map, it looks like this. And on a sort of like an A to Z of London, it looks rather like this. So, as I said, it's a lovely day out here. You've all heard all about me. I'm doing the easy bit, but this guy is doing the hard bit. Hello, Alistair.
Hello.
So, how are you feeling today, Ali?
Hot.
Hot. It is hot. It's a beautiful day. I can't believe the weather today. It's fantastic. Absolutely. You can see the blue sky behind us here. Do you think you'll manage the 32 minutes that I'm supposed to be doing?
Well, it's about a 4 mile, 6.5k route I've got to do. There's multiple things that could get in the way. Traffic. There's a swing bridge into the Isle of Dogs that might be up and raised.
Swing bridge.
So
okay.
No good to me if it's... I can't swim.
That's very true.
So I'm hoping if I get a good run, I can do about 31, 32 minutes. So it's going to be close, really close.
Good, good. Well, that's what these races are all about. I mean, Alistair does put a lot of time into getting the times as close as possible. So it becomes a proper kind of race rather than it being a one horse race because somebody's going to get there far quicker than anybody else. I, for myself, it was all down to the times, the changes that I've got to make. I believe Canning Town, Poplar, even Canary Wharf as well. And then I've got a little bit of running to do myself from Greenwich Station to the front of the station. It's not as easy and not as near as you think, as you will see later on the video. So, are you ready to go, Ali?
As ever.
I think I'm the same. Let's get this over and done with. See you later.
See you in a bit. Now the race, my watch starts when those doors shut. Have a good journey, babe. See you later. Those doors are shut, I can go. And we start with stairs.
Yeah,
is the train line he'll actually be on. Haven't seen him go by. It's
probably ahead, to be fair, at this point. Oh, I think I've already was taking a wrong turn, yeah. Oh, this won't help. I wonder if he's on there. Didn't see him. Okay, and I've burned it. I've now got to a point. Oh, I've got to a point where you just couldn't get over. One of the ways, I have to remember this route, by the way. I've got nothing on my watch to tell me. One of my turns, I remembered this hotel here. Or it might be a block of flats, but either way, the balconies kind of remind me of the balconies you see at the hotel at MCO Airport, if you've ever been. Probably doesn't look anything like them really, but to me, that's how I remembered. That fly over there, it's another DLR line, one he will be going on. Dogs, which is over my right shoulder. You might have seen O2 as well, or Millennium Dome. You'll see it better in a bit. Currently pacing 4:35, averaging 5 because of that traffic light stop. This is a swing bridge. It lets your big ships into the main part of the Isle of Dogs. What a view! Millennium Dome, O2 Arena. Wish I could enjoy it more. Here we are, London's Beach. It's quite a gritty one. That is the River Thames. So when the tide's high, beach gone. What a great view of the Millennium Dome again. Right, this is where I get lost. Not sure of the route through the house and estate. I think I know it. Soon find out. Those of you who don't know London, for those of you who have looked at the maps, I start on the north side of the Thames. I finish on the south. How do I get over the Thames? I go under the Thames. Keep watching, find out more. This is the Greenwich Foot Tunnel. The lift's out of order, so it's stairs. And I'm not running down these because my legs are wobbly. Oh, get a breather, I think. So, this is the Greenwich Foot Tunnel. Goes right under the River Thames. Pulls you out actually at Greenwich. For those of you who have seen the London Marathon, you come out by Cutty Sark. I'll try and hit some film. Of course it's great, I'll go under. But then I'm going to climb up. And I've got stairs the other end as well. So let's see how that goes.
Thank you.
while I'm here, and he isn't. So there we are. That's a finally won a race between this time between, as I say, Star Lane and Greenwich. So it's now 2-1 to Alistair at the moment, and hopefully some of this footage unfortunately didn't turn out for me, but hopefully we can catch a lot of Alistair's as well. So well, on to the next one. Hopefully the next one will probably be a few months away now, where we go back to Leicester to do the 58 challenge, where he will run a bus route and I will of course catch the bus route. See you then.
Now. That's 2 minutes in. I think he might have beat me. Hopefully you had bad connection somewhere. We'll find out soon as we go to the station. Oh. He's already here.
Well, here we are at the end of the race then. We've all had a bit of a relaxing time now to try and catch up, and it was quite some going, even for me. I mean, I had the easy bit, but up and down the stairs and running to the front of Greenwich Station in the heat was pretty hot. But we are now down here at the side of the Thames to give you a summary of how it went. I was lucky. I had a fairly good connection at Canning Town. And then when I got to Poplar, as you will see in the video, it was actually quicker to carry on to West Ferry and then go down underneath and back up the other side and change there, rather than wait the 8 minutes that I would have had to wait just to go around the corner of Canary Wharf and change again. So it's nice that I finally won a race. I look forward to the next one now. Thank you.
Retired Rover, pull yourself in for a second on the...
I'm here.
Now, what you guys don't know, and I didn't know until we got to the end, we planned a DLR route and my running routes. It turns out somebody went rogue whilst they were running. Whilst they were on...
Rogue? How did I go rogue? Me? Are you insinuating, Mr. Alistair, that I did not follow the correct procedure here?
Not just insinuating.
I actually used my initiative. Like I say, at Poplar, 8 minute wait... Take a gamble, carry on to the next station, and it worked.
He did take a slightly different route. However, it turned out it's still all on the DLR, so it's perfectly allowed.
Thank you.
I think it was about 4 minutes you beat me by in the end.
About four and a half, yeah.
About four and a half. So that makes it 2-1 in our race whatever.
In our running challenge series, I would call it.
Yeah, so we've done one tube, one bus, one DLR.
And then next we're doing a bus again, are we not, in Leicester? Is that the next one?
I don't know, I think I'm retired now.
retired Rover the second, perhaps?
Junior. Right, okay.
Yeah, okay.